as aquaculture grows very, very quickly, we must make sure that not only it is economically feasible, but also, and not less important, it is environmentally responsible. And this is what we are here to do. The Recirculating Aquaculture Salmon Network, it is a stakeholder, industry-driven partnership in its objectives and goals. The Recirculating Aquaculture Salmon Network was established to build capacity for the rapidly emerging and growing land-based Atlantic salmon aquaculture industry. So while this industry is more or less ready to be implemented and scaled up, there are still several challenges to this industry. And this is why our network was established. And together we are looking at what are those bottlenecks, what are those challenges that we need to address in order to ensure the success of this emerging but fast growing industry in the United States.
Consortia like Rasen provide a means for interested parties to come together, to share, and to learn from one another. And I think that's really where the core value of Rasen is. By bringing folks together, you can also help to draw attention to aquaculture and recirculating aquaculture specifically, and really raise its profile in the public consciousness. Efforts to communicate what contemporary aquaculture really is really important.
I feel the Rasen Network is really remarkable in that the group has been able to organize itself, covering all faucets of academia and industry at such an early stage of the RAS sector's growth. I think that will give the industry an advantage to have, you know, highlighted needs of the industry articulated to government and supporting sectors like educational institutes to set the framework for significant growth and potentially avoid some of the road bumps other emerging industries have faced.
I think one of the best outcomes of the Rasen Network is that we did establish research priorities working with the industry. The industry listed what those research priorities are. And now we've created a white paper that we can share with funding agencies and our political entities moving forward, exactly what we need to have funded for doing research in developing a sustainable recirculating aquaculture industry.
So the most exciting aspect of Recirculating Aquaculture Salmon Network to me and Superior Fresh has been that it resulted in a prioritized list of research needs that will improve the industry. And some of those needs are, how do we ensure that the product quality is the best, or that we have the very best feeds for the fish? And it allows the industry to share what's most critical with the academics that can do that work, and also with the funding agency. It has also led to a new project, SAS Squared, which the USDA has funded over the next 5 years, and I think will be making more large steps towards improving the tools we have to raise salmon on land-based systems.
So all those ideas that we have identified on paper, in the concept paper and the strategic plan, are now going to be addressed hands-on. We were awarded $10 million by the USDA to take the Rasen concept paper and deliverable from theory to conclusion in terms of carrying out what needs to be done: research and development, education, training, workforce development, and extension.